Surgical procedures for atrial fibrillation are called Cox-Mays procedures in recognition of the pioneering work done by Cox and his colleagues. Initial work on AF from this group was left atrial isolation. Though this produced sinus rhythm in right atrium, left atrium continued to fibrillate and was a source for thromboembolism. In the initial Mays procedure, position of the sinus node was identified and atriotomies were made surrounding it on three sides to allow impulse propagation in only one direction. Additional incisions were made to direct impulses to all areas of the atrium while interrupting all possible macro reentrant circuits in the atrium. Please subscribe to this channel for future updates. Click on the subscribe button. Press the bell icon after that for all updates. This prevented atrial fibrillation and restored atrioventricular synchrony. The first Mays procedure was done on 25th September 1987. Two important problems with Mays 1 procedure were chronotropic incompetence of the sinus node and occasional left atrial dysfunction. In Mays 2, the incision through the sinus node area in the high lateral right atrium was skipped. The transverse incision at the roof of the left atrium was moved posteriorly to permit better intra-atrial conduction. But Mays 2 had a problem in that it was necessary to transect the superior vena cava to expose the left atrium. In Mays 3, placing the septal incision posterior to the opening of the superior vena cava improved the exposure of the left atrium. Higher rates of sinus rhythm were achieved by Mays 3 procedure and they had improved long-term sinus node function. Atrial transport function was better and the need for pacemaker was lesser and so was arrhythmia recurrence. Later, it has been performed as a minimally invasive procedure with right submammary incision and even without cardiopulmonary bypass. Even in Mays 3, multiple atrial incisions were required, contributing to morbidity and complexity of the procedure. In 1990s, the first cryo-Mays procedures were performed, with cryoablation replacing the surgical incisions with transmural ablation lines. The first non-cut-and-sew Mays procedure with cryo was performed in 1999. In Mays 4, pulmonary veins are isolated bilaterally and a connecting lesion was also made. Since then, various energy sources like radio frequency, high frequency ultrasound, microwave and laser have been used for creating the ablation lines in Mays procedure. Here are a couple of journal references on Cox-Mays procedure. Please don't forget to subscribe to this channel for future updates and click on the bell icon for all updates. Thank you.